circumstances. We're still very much in COVID-19. It hasn't disappeared. A time and attention has been elsewhere, but it's very much our present, and it's going to be our future until there is a viable vaccine, and we have no idea when that's going to happen. You think about Lollapalooza, and we've had extensive discussions with the owners of Lollapalooza, who are terrific people. But the reality is, bringing 100,000 people in mass, in close quarters, which is what the daily headcount is every single day of Lollapalooza, bringing that many people from all over the country downtown in Grant Park every single day, we might as well just light ourselves on fire. It makes sense. Given what we know about how this disease spreads, which is close, intimate contact extended over 10 realistically, we are not going to be in a position to have those kinds of large gatherings for some time. And it's heartbreaking because Lollapalooza is fun. Our outdoor music festivals are fun. A lot of things about Chicago in the summertime are fun. And we are looking at ways, and I hope we don't get lost in the DK's announcement, to do a lot of those performances virtually. And still give people the opportunity to taste Chicago, no pun intended, but do it virtually. And we're also looking at some other alternatives where we can bring together people safely. There's a lot of interesting things that are going on really across the country, but also across the world, that I think that we will stand up here in Chicago in lieu of these large mass outdoor gatherings.